Okay, hello everyone. Welcome to another one of my Life of Life talks. If you are live with me now, I apologize because I already did this talk just now for 20 minutes and apparently it didn't run. So there was a software glitch, so I have to do it all over again. So I'm sorry if you're waiting for this to listen to this live and nothing happened. You know, technology was fighting me. So, you know. And maybe you still find this and you can watch it as a recording. So my name is Ken Santranto. I'm a spiritual teacher, personal spiritual life coach. And I do these Life of Life talks to hopefully enlighten you a little bit how spirituality applies to your life. What spirituality is after all. So this is why I, you know, encourage you to live a life of light, live a life of your own choosing, live a life that is fueled by your own love and your own desire and, you know, make it happen for you. And when I do these talks, the titles, I receive these titles from my inner guidance. I don't make them up. I just kind of listen and ask. And as of late, I have been surprised by some titles being very religious, like this one. What is the Holy Trinity? So this is the title I received. So I was like, okay, you know. And the question that I would have, why does it matter? You know, how does that matter to me? So we will get to that, I promise. I will tell you exactly how the Holy Trinity works in your life and what you can do with it. But first, let's just go a little bit into spiritual theory, spiritual tradition, because I, you know, I Googled a little bit. Coming from a Christian upbringing myself, from a Christian cultural background, the Trinity that was known to me was the one of Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. And when you look into Christian theology, it is said that God presents itself in these three different aspects. They say each aspect is distinct, unique. At the same time, God is not divided, so this principle cannot be separated from each other. So you can experience each principle as a very distinct, unique connection point to this idea what, you know, what God is in your life. At the same time, it all belongs together. So when you look into Buddhism, they have the same. They have exactly the same. So it's called the Trikaya. The three aspects of the Trikaya, these are Sanskrit words now. The first one is the Dharmakaya, which is called the body of ultimate reality. This would be the Father in Christian tradition. Second one is called the Sambhogakaya, the body of joy. So the body of joy is obviously the Holy Spirit, inspiration. The third one is the Nirmanakaya, which is the Buddha's human body of flesh and blood. So same. And if you go to the Indian religion, which some people call Hinduism, but actually it's called Sanatana Dharma, it's called the eternal path. The idea of that is that this represents the spiritual truth behind all the other traditions, like the oldest teachings. They try to describe principles that are true for everyone. They have the Trimurti, which is called, that is their trinity, is the Trimurti, which is Brahma, Shiva, and Vishnu. So Brahma, again, would be the father, the you know, the god that is unchangeable and the creator god. Vishnu would be the sun. This is the god that sustains creation. And you have Shiva, which is sometimes called the destroyer, but he's more the principle of change, and with that also of inspiration. So Shiva is the Holy Spirit, because inspiration changes something within you. It, you know, puts old ideas into perspective, brings new ideas into your life. So we have it again. So most spiritual traditions somehow have this triple principle, and also in fairy tales you always have three wishes, and the number three is really like a number that goes throughout the human world, the human culture. And so Trinity seems to be a principle that is fundamentally embedded in creation. Of course, This can be confusing because I remember myself when I started to be interested in spirituality, I would read different spiritual theories, different spiritual traditions, and I would get confused because so many things that these scholars of the different traditions said seem to be contradicting each other. That is true. They do contradict each other, but behind all these intellectual musings, there is a principle where they come from. The principle of Trinity is something that you can find in your own life if you look at it in a very simple way. Here's my suggestion how you look at this principle of Trinity in your life. So the Trinity for your life is this: heaven, earth, and you. So these are the three principles that I would suggest you try to see and try to embrace and try to love equally. So let's look at each of them, see what they mean. The first one, heaven. Heaven is not that place that you go to when you die. It's like a price that you get for having lived a good life. Heaven is a principle that is available to you at all times. So heaven is the principle of everything that you are, because you are more than your body. Without your ideas, without your love, without your goals, your body would just be an empty shell. So there is something fueling this body. There's someone in this body that makes it move, makes it speak, makes it act, and that is you. That is your soul. So this entirety of your personality is a spiritual being, much bigger than just the human being. This entirety of your qualities, that is heaven. And it's a really, really healthy, good idea to ask for that connection to your heaven, to really dare to follow your intuition, to dare to live life the way you want to live life, to approach problems that you want to approach problems. Of course, you can be inspired by other people that give you ideas how to approach the problem, but at the end of the day, when all is said and done, you are the one who has to live your life, and your heaven will provide you the way and the solutions that you need. Yeah, so heaven is all that you are, all that you can do, and ultimately all that you came here to realize. Earth, principle number two. Earth is the theater of life. It's a theater of the stage of the play that you are the main character in. You are the protagonist in your own story, and Earth is the stage. And as such, Earth provides you with resources, but also with limits. So it's a life of limitation. So I'd like to be able to fly, but currently I have to use an airplane to do it. I can't just levitate. I wish I could, but I can't. So that's a limitation. This is just part of this theater, and again, it is tremendously important and tremendously advisable to embrace the natural law of life on Earth. Don't fight it. Use it as an inspiration. That's a fine distinction. So if life presents you with a problem, yes, you should try to overcome this problem, but you should use this as an inspiration, and you should not see the problem in your life as something wrong. The problem is just pushing you, encouraging you, guiding you to embrace something from your heaven, the solution to your problem. So this is why we have this stage, because we probably wouldn't do anything if we weren't prompted by challenges. So if everything was just fine and dandy, there were milk and honey flowing, and just have to open our hands and we'd have the food we need, and we just think of our life partner, and there she or he stands. We wouldn't strive for growth. That stage, Earth, does not necessarily punish you, it just shows you what's real and what's not. And real is your heaven is real, your goals are real, your ambitions are real. At the same time, you have to make them real in this theater, which is not that easy, which requires effort and persistence. And so you have to embrace this this second part of your personal trinity as equally important. It's tremendously important who you are. Your heaven is tremendously important. It's tremendously important the stage and the theater and the rules of life that you find yourself in. And number three is you. So what is this you? This you that I'm, because all of that is you. But this you, this principle of Trinity is really the person that you are. So that's what in Buddhism was called, let me look it up, the Nirmanakaya, the Buddha's body. So this Buddha's body is this one, and your Buddha's body is your body. So it's, your body is the vehicle for your story. It's the vehicle for your personal growth. It's also the most importantly, possibly, it's just a perspective. You see life currently through this body. I see this computer in front of me through my eyes. You hear me through your ears. You smell your coffee through your nose. So this is the vehicle of your story, and the way to be complete is to understand all these three principles and to embrace them all. And depending what your issue is, depending what your challenge is, you have to focus on one of them more than on the other. So, for example, if you need inspiration, if you're at your wit's end, you have a problem that you can solve, focus on your heaven, because your heaven has that solution. You will not find it in your body. The solution, the new solution, that step of growth in your life comes from your inspiration. And spiritual practice is helpful to do that. Meditation, becoming still, becoming empty, or having a coach, a mentor who can guide you through a guided meditation into this corner, if you will, of your heaven that has the solution. So this is a shortcut that I wholeheartedly recommend to find a spiritual teacher, a spiritual consultant, whom you trust, whom you have faith in, and ask them, okay, can you help me navigate my heaven to the solution that I need? But for example, if you're too invested in your heaven and your body starts to wither away, it may be time to take a walk, to exercise, to go on vacation, to have a nice meal, to meet with friends. So you, when you neglect the physical, again, your path cannot complete itself, because if you're too fragile or too sick, if you don't take care of this vessel, you, it is much more difficult to continue your journey. You're stuck. You first then will be stuck for a long, long time taking care of your body. So sometimes, you know, if you simply put, have a physical problem, take care of it. Do something with and through your body to distribute the life energy within you better, so that your body functions again as what it should be, a joyful vehicle for your story. So then, of course, maybe you are, you know, meditating a lot and you're very spiritual and you're taking care of your body, but you forget to pursue your story. This is when you have to focus on Earth. So what is the current situation in your life on Earth? So is it a happy one? Is it a fulfilled one? Or do you need to retreat from your physical life because you cannot bear it? So then it's the time to focus on Earth, which in that case would mean your concrete life. So do you have an issue with the person that's close to you that really makes your life miserable and you need to solve it? Yeah, focus on that. So, but ideally, focus on all three, because, you know, for your problem on earth, you can use heaven's inspiration, but then you have to apply it in this world, this life. So you need all three. So Trinity is you being complete in this experience. Heaven, earth, and you, it's all equally important. And it's like a dance. It's like a, or maybe like a kaleidoscope, you know, which is, has many facets, but at the end it's just one light that goes in, and it's one object. A kaleidoscope is just one object that produces these beautiful, colorful images, and the same goes for your life. Your life is complex. Life has many, many different facets, many different phases, but at the end of the day, the Trinity is always there. Heaven, you, and Earth. So embrace that. If you need some help with it, feel free to contact me. You know, I'll be happy to be that guide who guides you into your body or your heaven or your earth to figure out which aspects of yourself have to shake hands to support you and to solve your issue to a successful life. A life of light, as I call it. So thank you for listening. I hope this time this thing goes live. I wish you a wonderful day and hope to see you in my next talk very soon. Take care. Bye-bye.